this video is about recording guitars at home with an isolation box, a homemade isolation box. I will show you how to build one, what it sounds like, how to record with it, and so on. Okay, so the basic idea why you would actually want to use an isolation box is, since recording electric guitars could be quite loud and the neighbors will complain and call the police, you have the isolation box to make it quiet on the outside. You can turn your tube amp as loud as you want, and it still won't disturb anyone. Okay, so this is what it looks like from the outside, and let's have a look on the inside. You basically have a guitar cabinet with microphones in front of it, small mic stands, acoustic foam on all sides, also on the top. For the walls we have acoustic foam, then this is some wooden floor lamination that was quite cheap, so I put it in. Then one layer of plywood, on top we have window isolation, then another this lamination thing, then plywood again with window isolation, and that's it. I built it with two layers of plywood just to be sure that it's really quiet from the outside, but usually just acoustic foam and one layer of plywood should be enough. Okay, you also need the speaker cable from the amp going to the guitar cabinet and also from the microphone to the preamp. This is the top. I routed out some wood here for the cables to go through. And also here on this side, I took a wooden file and rounded off the edges a bit. So this is where the cables will go in. Yeah, you don't really need two microphones. One should also be enough. Okay, so if you want to build one, you just take measurements of your guitar cabinet, add some extra space for the acoustic foam and for the microphones. Then what I did, I went to a hardware store and they cut the plywood pieces together for me. So the walls and the top. The floor. At home I just glued the walls together, and also I used these L profiles to also screw the edges together. And to be able to open and close it, this is the inner lid. I put on those handles to be able to pull it out. For the top lid I just took some door hinges, which can be seen here. The top can be closed like this. Okay, so in total it was quite easy to build. If you ever made something out of wood, then this shouldn't be any problem. Okay, once it's all set up, what you need to find is the proper mic placement. And since opening and closing the isolation box takes a little time, here's one secret trick how you can find the mic placement more quickly. Okay, so the quick way to find the proper mic placement is setting up an amp and a preamp. And what I'll do is, I will play the guitar, it will come out of the speaker into the microphone, into the preamp, and I will listen to what the microphone is hearing over the headphones. I will move around the microphone until it sounds right. Okay, so let's hear the difference between having the master volume quite low and then really high. But now it's low around the room level and the preamp volume is high. We'll play something. And now with the master volume high. The question now is, how loud is it in the room? What you'll be hearing is just the room microphone and the amp turned way up and the sound is coming through the box. Let's hear how loud it is. So the actual guitar is still a bit louder acoustically than what's coming from the amp, so this shouldn't be any problem when recording at home. Okay, that's it. I hope I went through everything that should be interesting. So if you want to record with your real amps, then isolation box is something that you can do. If you want to listen to some more sound examples, I will put up some links to my older videos. These days I'm recording differently, but I wanted to make this video to pass on the knowledge in case anyone else wants to build an isolation box. Yeah, if you have any questions, you can post it in the comments. Yeah, until next time, goodbye.